Hi guys, and welcome to another WordPress Divi Theme e-commerce site build. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, a lot of people have asked me about adding products that are variable. So say you've got shirts with different colors or trousers with different colors and sizes. How do you actually add those to your product list and get them all displaying? Well, I covered this in one of the courses I do, which is how to build a free e-commerce theme with WordPress on the Udemy platform. There's a discount link for this course just below the video. And I'm going to put in one of the lectures from there to explain how this is done. So here we go. So if we go back to our dashboard, and to our products, funnily enough, then we'll hit the add new up here. Now again, we're going to start with a simple product and turn it into a variable product. So I'm going to call it striped shirt. And we'll give it some lorem ipsum just as filler text. And we'll add our image as usual. And don't forget to put in your alt text if you want to do some SEO on that. Just add something appropriate about your image there. Insert it into our thing. I'm going to align it right once again, left click and align right. And we'll just put this in for the short description down here. Set our product image, the same image we're going to use right here. Okay, so at the moment we've got a simple product. We'll give it a regular price, say $15. We won't make it on sale just yet. Now, just flipping down to inventory, to in stock, that's fine. Shipping, give it a shipping weight, whatever the shipping weight is, I don't know, £1, how much does a shirt weigh? And we, as we said before, shipping classes you have to create for your area. And once you've created those, you can just add one here. Okay, let's give it some attributes first. Attributes are things like size and color and what have you. So if we hit the add button. Okay, and we'll say size. And we'll enter what sizes we've got. And as you can see, it's separated. Whatever you enter here, you want to separate it by a pipe. And that's that vertical line there. And that's usually located on a US keyboard just above the enter key if you hit shift. And it's just on the same key as the backspace usually. But let's do small pipe, medium pipe, large, and another pipe, and XL, which is extra large, presumably. That's fine. And now let's add some others. Let's say we've got some different colors of this particular shirt. So underneath, it's opened another box underneath here. So I'm going to do color. And we've got grey. type, we've got red type, we've got blue type, and we've got green. So that's fine. We'll save that. Now that that's saved, let's go and change this to a variable product. And we've created the attributes. We've got our size and we've got our color. Now we want to create the variations. We need to check the little box underneath visible on product page, and it says used for variations. And again with our color, used for variations, save attributes. And let's go down to variations and add a variation. And if you hit this little arrow just to the right here, it gives you the option to create variations from all attributes. And what that means, it's going to create a small, medium, large, and extra large for each color that we've got going there. So I'm going to check on that and hit go. Yep, I want to link all variations. And it's added the variations. Now here's all our possible variations, XL, large, medium, small, in all the different colors here. And we can go through and we can add separate images, green, blue, red, and gray for each of these, you know, if you've got a product with different colors there. Now you can also select a different price if you want to. So, you know, the XLs we can make a little bit more expensive, say $20. The weight, we'll just leave that blank because it's going to be the same. Shipping class, same as parents. Tax class, same. And we'll upload an image by selecting the little image icon here. So we can set our green image there. And our blue image here. And our red image here. And finally our gray image here. If you decide that you've got too many variations going on, I'll just close these up a minute. I'm just clicking on the little arrow that's over on the right hand side. It's not visible until you actually mouse over it. But if you, you know, have a look and say, well, it's too many variations, I don't want that many, I just want sort of a few, you can just remove the ones you don't want over on the right hand side. You see this little remove tag here. Okay, so no point you watching me do all of these, so I'm going to pause this and I'll just finish off doing the rest of these just like we've been doing there. Okay, we're back. I've been in and I've put in the variations. I've given a different price for the extra large, the large, and the medium. What we'll do is I'll add the different colors to the product gallery there, so you've got all of them in there. So it's control and click and it'll select them all. Okay, so that should do it. And product tags, remember you can help your SEO by putting in anything about your product there. Now we want to add a new category and call it shirts, I guess. So I think that's just about everything. Let's publish it and take a look. Obviously, depending on what products you're selling, as to how complex your variables need to be. And if you get into this, there are all kind of plugins out there. If there's something you need to do, there will be a plugin that will enable you to do it. Far too many to go over in this course. But anyway, so we saved that. Let's preview our changes now. Here it is. And as you see, we've got these boxes up here with the sizes and the colors. And under the price, it's given a variation of $16 to $20 because I've got the small starting at 16 and the extra large at 20. So if we choose, at the moment you can't add anything to your cart because you need to choose an option. So let's say extra large, gray. Let's choose a different color. We've already got the gray up there, red. And you see the red shirt appears and the price changes to 20. If we want the red one in medium, it changes to 18. You can still add it to your cart and what have you and decide how many you want with the plus and minus buttons there. So that's how to add a variable product. And if we go home, they should have appeared on our front page here as well in our shop page. Yep, here's our shirts here. So that is how you add a variable product. Well, I hope you found that useful. If you did, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. If you're interested in web development, take a look at some of our courses below. We've got some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. There's also some great free courses down there, so do check it out. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.